let's go over when is the best time to eat your carbohydrates within a meal if you're looking to lose some weight and actually improve your health. Like for example, I had a personal training client who every single night had to have like Italian bread before his dinner. He was taking in an extra like 200-300 calories of just white bread. And in my opinion, if you want to lose some weight, if you can eliminate empty calories like white bread, like Italian bread, it's going to be a lot easier for you to drop the weight. Plus, this Italian bread was giving him a big spike in insulin. And when insulin levels high, you know, insulin is that storage hormone, it's really hard to burn body fat. And this was somewhat of a non-negotiable thing for him. He said, Mike, I've been eating bread since I'm a kid before every meal. I'm not stopping. I'm not giving up my bread. So when I have a client like that, that's somewhat challenging to find a solution for his problem to lose weight, I had to do a lot of research. And I came across a study. This study is back in 2015, talking about when you eat your carbohydrates, when you eat your bread within a meal, can have a major effect on blood glucose levels and insulin levels. And this study talked about that all you have to do is eat your bread at the end of a meal as opposed to the beginning of a meal, and that's gonna help you lose weight, control blood sugar, control insulin levels. So that's what I wanna talk about in this video. Let's go over the study, and then we'll give you some practical tips at the end of the study that you can use to help you lose weight and improve your health by timing when you consume your carbohydrates within a meal. Now, if you don't know who I am, if you're new to my channel, my name is Mike Cola. I've been a fitness trainer and gym owner for over 30 years. I literally have helped thousands of people lose weight and just get into fantastic shape. Okay, let's go over this study. It was actually done on type 2 diabetics, and what the researchers did is that for 1 week, they had the participants actually eat their carbohydrates before the meal. For example, they would have some bread and they would have a glass of actually orange juice. You know, bread and orange juice will give you a nice spike in blood sugar, a nice spike in insulin. Then they had the participants wait 15 minutes, and then they had their protein, which was chicken breast, a little bit of like broccoli, a little bit of high fiber type carbohydrate, a low glycemic type carbohydrate. Like vegetables that are high fiber will not spike insulin, will not spike blood sugar anywhere near as much as say white bread or orange juice, which is like kind of a much more higher sugar type carbohydrate. And then they had a little bit of butter on the broccoli. Okay, and they ate this way for 1 week, and then 30 minutes, 60 minutes, and I think it was 90 minutes post-meal after the meal, the research had measured their blood glucose levels and their insulin levels. So just so you know, for example, whenever you eat food and sugars released into the bloodstream, the body doesn't like anywhere more than about 5 grams of sugar in the bloodstream at any one time. And once the blood glucose levels go above that, you know, the pancreas produces insulin to lower your blood sugar and store away those excess calories. Okay, so then they took the same group of people, they waited a week, and the second week, they just changed the order of the carbohydrates. For example, they had them eat first the protein, the chicken breast, the broccoli, and the butter. Then they waited 15 minutes, and then they had the bread and the orange juice, and they followed the same procedure. They measured blood glucose and insulin levels 30, 60, and 90 minutes after the meal. Now let's go over the results of the study. In week 2, when the participants had their protein before the carbohydrate, for example, they had their chicken, the broccoli, the butter before the bread and the juice, and then when they measured blood glucose levels 30 minutes after the meal, that group had a 27% lower blood glucose level for the same person, for the same people that the week before had their bread and juice before the meal. 60 minutes after the meal, there was a 37% improvement in blood glucose level. And then 90 minutes after the meal, there was a 17% improvement of blood glucose and insulin levels. And this is actually a big takeaway. This is actually a tremendous difference. Just think, people are eating the same amount of calories, the same exact foods, but just by changing the order in which you eat those hypoglycemic, those sugary carbohydrates, you can have dramatic improvements in blood glucose levels and insulin levels. And in my opinion, I'm also a big believer in just eating a low carbohydrate diet in general. In my opinion, low carbohydrate eating, as long as you keep your protein high, is a great way to burn body fat, to keep your weight under control. And really what it does, it increases your insulin sensitivity, which is, for me, the key to good health and to controlling your weight. Like, for example, if you're eating in a way where you're constantly spiking insulin and keeping insulin levels always high, you're gonna have a really hard time burning fat. Because when insulin is high, you're not burning calories, you're storing away excess calories. And this is incredible. So that's what I did with my client. We made a little change. All he had to do, I said, you know, you can eat your bread, but do me a favor. Eat your meal first, have your protein, have your vegetables, have your core meal first, but then after the meal, then you can have your 200-300 calories of bread. And actually it did work, and I have to say, it didn't work dramatically for him. He lost a few pounds and but he was really happy. But it's, you know, when it comes to losing weight, you have to find a diet, you have to find an approach that's realistic for you. I've talked about this before. I have this thing called the 95% rule. Whenever it comes to like a diet, an exercise program, or anything in your life that you want to do, you have to be 95% sure that you're going to do it or it's not going to work. And this is something, when I asked him, I said, could you do that? Could you eat your bread at the end of the meal? And he said, yeah, Mike, that I can do. I can't give it up, but I can eat it at the end of a meal. So this is something that you may want to start experimenting with. Now, if you like those high sugary, empty calorie type carbohydrates, and you still want to control insulin levels, control blood sugar, if you don't want to become a diabetic, right? Type 2 diabetes, we don't want that. None of us want that. At least try having these type of carbohydrates at the end of the meal. And what I forgot to mention is that they waited 15 minutes. So that's what we did. For example, you eat your chicken, you eat your broccoli, you have your butter, you have your normal meal, you wait 15 minutes, and then you have your high glycemic type carbohydrate. And this is also another strategy that I've been using for a long time when it comes to when I'm only eating one meal a day. Like, if you also follow me on YouTube, you know I'm a big believer in intermittent fasting. And about once a week, maybe twice a week, I do an OMAD diet, meaning that I only eat one meal a day. So I will literally fast for say 22, 23 hours the entire day. And then I have one big feasting type meal. And this is an adjustment that I made, you know, some time ago. For example, I'll eat my protein and my fats together in one meal. So for example, for dinner, say I'll have a nice big piece of salmon. I like to keep my protein up. I'll eat like a pound of salmon. Then I'll have my high fiber type vegetables. I may have some broccoli. I may have some cauliflower. But then if I want a high glycemic type carbohydrate, I literally, because I'm giving myself a 1 hour eating window, I'll wait 20, 30, 40 minutes, sometimes even I'll push it as far as I can, and then maybe I'll have a sweet potato or a white potato. And that's definitely made a big difference for me for keeping my body fat levels low. So something you may want to experiment. Now, if you want to learn about what I think is the best way to eat like low carb with intermittent fasting, whole natural foods, check out this playlist of videos.